So this video is going to focus on how to solve a logarithmic equation. So I have the following equation on the board, and we're going to go ahead and just jump into this problem. So there are a few different rules that we do need to be aware of in order to complete this problem. So there is the product rule of logs, there's a quotient rule of logs, there's an exponent one, there's a few different variations of, I would highly recommend looking those up and becoming a little bit familiar with them. So, taking a look at this problem, on the left-hand side, I see that I have log of 3 plus x minus log of x minus 3. And what I want to do with this equation is I want to try and simplify it a little bit. I want to try and combine it, reduce it a little bit. Because taking a look at what I have right now, there's not a whole bunch I can do here. I don't want to move things around to either side of the equation. I kind of want to compact it a little bit more. And the way that I can do that is by paying attention to this minus sign here. When it comes to logs, a minus sign translates to the quotient rule. The quotient rule says that when you are subtracting two logs together of the same base, you can combine them by doing a division. What that's going to look like, we're going to combine these two into one, so I'm going to keep the log. If there's not a base there, it's understood to be 10, so this is log base 10. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the first one divided by the second one. That is what the quotient rule is telling me that I can do. So that means I'm going to have log of 3 plus x over the x minus 3. I don't have to add the log over here because I'm combining it all into 1. So again, a minus sign translates to a division sign. Had it been a plus sign, I would be multiplying these together. I would have done 3 plus x times x minus 3 had this been a plus sign here. So a plus sign is a multiplication, a minus sign is a division. That is very, very important for you to remember. So, and this is just going to be equal to the log of 5. So now since I have a log base 10 on the left, log base 10 on the right hand side, and this equation is pretty much saying that they are equal to each other. So if they are equal to each other, what I'm going to be able to do then is I can drop the logs from the problem. And I can just state that this is 3 plus x over x minus 3 is equal to 5. And this drops this down to a basic equation that we can solve here. So this kind of just brings it down to solving equation rules, right? Making sure what we do to one side of the equation, we do to the other side. The whole point from here on out is to solve for x and get x completely by itself. So using the rules of equations, so I see I have my two x's over here on the left-hand side. I see there's a division going on. Remember, when it comes to solving equations, we want to do the opposite of what we have. So the opposite of a division is a multiplication. So instead of dividing by x minus 3, I'm going to multiply by x minus 3. That multiplication is going to cancel on the left-hand side, allowing me to drop down the 3 plus x. And on the right-hand side, we had 5. We're multiplying it to the x minus 3. So that means we are going to use the distributive property in order to multiply by that 5. So 5 times the x gives us 5x minus 5 times the 3 is a 15. So from here on out, let's see, I want to get my x togethers. So I can essentially want to combine my variables. I want to combine my numbers. If I combine my variables, I have an x here on the left-hand side. I have a 5x on the right-hand side. So I'm going to combine them all together on the right-hand side. This x is technically a 1x. Excuse me. And it is positive. So what I want to do, if I want to get rid of it and move it to the right-hand side, again, we do the opposite calculation of what we have. So instead of a plus x, I'm going to do a minus x on both sides. X minus x cancels on that left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, I have 5x minus x to give me 4x and drop down to minus 15. Since I got my variables together on the right-hand side, I need to move my numbers to the left-hand side. So this minus 15, I will do the opposite and add 15 to both sides. All right, so when we add that 15 to both sides, it is going to cancel out on the right-hand side. So that is going to leave us with a 4x on the right-hand side. And on the left-hand side, we had a 3. We added 15. That is now giving us an 18. The only thing left to do here to solve for x is to divide out the coefficient. So if we divide both sides by 4, we actually get that x is equal to, I believe, a 4.5 when we do that division there. So that actually solves the equation for us. So x is equal to 4.5, and that wraps up this problem.